1-1 so far in this series, and here we go. As the draw is controlled by the Red Wings. And on the far side, a good hit delivered along the boards. Bergevin for Detroit. Out top the boards to Cicerelli. Meanwhile, Bergevin got a big hit from Doan. Now carried on by Kachuk. He's knocked down by Johnson. Out of the line, Holtby. He got a heavy hit from Muni. The Jets trying to be physical here in the early going. And now Holtby Bulldog's going to take a whistle. He put it in behind the net. Now Jamie tried to center. Came back to put it in front. That is saved by Vernon.
Because nobody expected them to go more than five games against the Red Wings.
Constantino's pass to blocking, but captured by Kozlov, stepping and shooting, scores! Vyacheslav Kozlov up over the glove of Habibulin, and the first good chance of the game for Detroit goes in. It's 1-0.
Looked like Kozlov may have caught Habibulin moving. He moved to his left, and he snapped the puck before he really quit skating.
Chipped it up the middle, there's Primo. He streaks over the line, he's in on Tavernowski. He shot it just wide, and then dislodged the goal. Igor Korolev chipped on a half jam, knocked one-on-one with Constantino. Constantino played the body all the way. Rides him into the corner. Kozlov then mishandled it, but gets a little help. And Fedorov walks away for a check to center. Now has the line, but mishandled it there. Leading Manson to center. Dave Hanson on the table. Manson, who's got a great shot, fire about 100-footer. And it beat Vernon to the glove side, hit the inside of the post and came out.
Big, tall kid. Really went after Maltby. Doan took a big check.
On the Detroit power play, Konstantinov took a hit to feed Larionov. He put it to Fedorov. Fedorov gets things set up. Sergei Fedorov moves in. He's looking for his first goal of the series. He does have six helpers to lead the Detroit scoring list. Now Fetisov to Larionov to Fedorov. He whipped and he scores! What a good break for Kozlov. That pass was the attempted shot was missed and went right to Kozlov, and bang, it's 2-0.
Well, Mike Eastwood does pay the ultimate price in a bad penalty. And it's the last thing the Winnipeg Jets can afford to do.
Olchek for Kachuk. Into the Detroit zone, around the check. He cuts right in there. Shoots. And a save by Vernon.
It's back as that thing was sliding into the net.
Schick never indicated a goal. He's putting his hands down like the safe sign. He's going to go to the replay for sure. Well, that puck was up in the air and swatted in by a Jet player.
It looked like it was a high stick from up here. And indeed, they've ruled no goal.
And then Cicerelli didn't know the pass was coming. Here's a steal by Primo. Primo moves in there for Yzerman. And then he couldn't quite corral it. Back of the goal goes Primo. He's Primo center. Yzerman right in. He scores! Steve Yzerman left all alone in the goal mouth. Primo found him and bang. The Red Wing captain makes it 3-0. And this plays a little bit quieter than it was a few minutes ago.
Well, you know, after what happened Friday night when that man stopped 51 of 52 shots, the Red Wings got to be feeling, thank goodness, that we finally got something to go on this guy.
Even when he makes a mistake, he's so fast, he gets back and cover it up.
That's right.
What a beautiful skater. Here's Lidstrom. Big save by Habibulin with his shoulder. Long feed to Kilgar coming out of the penalty box. He moves in there, fires, and a save by Vernon. And a trickle pass in through the goal crease, but out the other side. Olchek on the right side. A drop pass for Tavernowski. Fires right on. Vernon fought it off. Rebound Yzerman. Meanwhile, Mickey Bergevin, who you mentioned left the ice, has returned. That was an equipment foul. We're going to have a penalty now. Big collision in the corner between McKenzie and Cicerelli. McKenzie's going to get the call. And now as the Jets control, the whistle sounds, and Jim McKenzie trying to stir it up. That spun along the end boards. Now Fedorov has it. His pass deflecting, and it's held into Larionov, and now we have Fedorov is shaken up. Fedorov is down. The play is continuing, and now the whistle sounds from Rob Schick, and Sergei Fedorov is down.
Well, Dave Manson can only hope that nobody saw this. He gave Fedorov a two-hander with the heel of the stick across the back of the leg. Primo's out on the ice now talking to Manson. Did you see Fedorov being helped off? And, of course, the point, Pat, is that It's one thing to get high-sticked or clipped or whatever, whatever, but when players deliberately take the stick and try to hurt somebody, and that's what they're giving it to Manson about, that's a different story.
And here comes Coffey. In over the line, racing in around Newman, and centered one. Here's a shot and a save by Javi Bulin as the second period comes to an end.
You get cold. Not having
is Chris Osgood acting up in class? How come he's sitting in jug? Kachuk got taken down as he tried to get to that. Oh, Kachuk just gave Vernon a little shot to the jaw.
Vernon was jawing at him and giving him some major chin music there, and Kachuk just gave him a little love tap on the face mask. Still in the business today with...
You've never met a loser guy either. Here come the Wings. Larry Onoff, a shot, a good save by Javi Bulin. Sends it in. Henson goes into the corner on Coffey. Kane loose to Cole. Feeding McIver right in. He shoots his goal.
This whole thing set up, Pat, when Detroit had possession behind the net and they gave it up.
Takes off from behind the net, slipped it in front. Larry Onoff had the puck at his feet. Now Muni hacked at it. And got it to center. Kachuk, he's hammered by Konstantinov. Just as the puck got there, so did Konstantinov, and he flattened Kachuk with a crunching hit. As a man with him, that's Draper. Taylor over the line for Draper to the backhand. He shoots. And a save by Javi Bulin. Made it to the far side. Good hit by Muni. Flatten Larry Onoff. Coffey in on Tabernoski. Got to the net, shoot. And a save by Javi Bulin. Battling with Newman and got it loose to Cicerelli. Dino with a chance for an empty net. The puck's rolling out and he shoots. And he shot it wide. But the clock continues to wind down. There's a steal by Primo, an empty netter, and Detroit has won the series. And they will advance to the second round to play the St. Louis Blues.
Ironically, that's Primo's first goal of the series. Standing, cheering their hockey club as they move on to Phoenix for next season.
And you're right, everybody in this place is standing and cheering. The game is over, the series is over, the history of the Jets in Winnipeg is over. And you're about to see one of the best traditions in all of sport as these teams, after going at it tooth and nail for six games, will line up and exchange handshakes. And the Red Wings certainly didn't feel it would have taken them this long. You have to give a tip of the hat, especially for the guy wearing the mask in the Winnipeg goal.
That's for sure, Pat. I don't think anybody expected that the Jets would even win one game, let alone two. And
so the ceremonial handshakes go on, and we'll come back here to the Winnipeg Arena in just a few moments. The Wings win the series, and this game today, 4-1. Folks, check this out. The game is over. The series is over. The players exchanged handshakes. They all left the ice. Then the Jets came back out onto the ice, taking a curtain call, a lap around, led by their captain, Keith Kachuk. Nobody in the stands has left this arena. They're all still standing and cheering. And there was the scene a moment ago as the Jet players came out to say thanks to the fans who have been so supportive. Now for Mickey Redmond, Pat Foley saying so long from the Winnipeg Arena. Detroit wins the series 4-2. They won this game.